All right. Thank you, Rani. Thank you, Shahrukh. Thank you, Kajol. And thank you to all everyone present from Dharma Productions. Kajol, do you have a last memory you want to share with us?
I think everybody's praised you enough now.
No, not me. I said the film. I'm not talking about me. I'm not talking about me.
Oh!
I'm not.
Thanks. I'm very upset with you. We'll have this chat later.
No, Kajol has been saying, why am I not having more fun on this show? So I'm like, this have is, to be a little more
I mean,
serious.
It's not a personal show at all. I mean, like, you know, we thought that we were coming for like a 20-year get-together of Kuch Kuch Hota Hai.
Kajol, this is now, we are older, we have to be more elegant. Like Farida ji just walked in and Farida ji will tell you how much...
Hi, Farida ji!
And she's been tortured enough by you in all those movies, so we just decided to keep
Anybody
it cool.
Anybody wants to crack a dirty joke?
No.
Okay.
No. You have anything to say, Kajol, or should I move on?
Move on.
All right, okay. Rani, you have a last memory.
I think I've said this several times in my interviews. Thank you, Shahrukh, for teaching me how to romance on screen. There's nobody.
Can you praise my tight t-shirts?
No. No. I just love your heart. I think Shahrukh has immense love.
And we can see it very clearly in the tight t-shirt.
Yes.
With my nipples.
So I don't think there's anybody who can romance like Shahrukh on screen. And I feel very blessed and lucky to have been one of his heroines who he's loved. Because when Shahrukh loves... I don't think there's anybody who loves like Shahrukh. So thank you, Shahrukh, for being so lovely. And I do remember...
Blush!
I do remember when we shot for the song in Scotland. I don't know whether you remember this, Shahrukh. But because it was my first romantic film, there were shots where Shahrukh was supposed to kiss me on the cheek. And I remember going, shifting my weight to the other side because I was so young and I was so... naive, I guess. I don't know.
She was 17 years old when she shot Kuch Kuch Hota
Hai.
19.
17.
17.
17.
Yeah. Oh, God.
So,
I didn't know that.
So thank you, Shahrukh, for making me feel so loved and teaching me actually how it is to romance on screen. So, thank you so much. I couldn't have it better in my career than to have Shahrukh Khan romance me and teach me how to romance. So, thank you.
And two people I suggested Rani to. One was Karan. And she became the Dharma heroine. One was Adi who married her. So my recommendation.
You've done very well.
100%.
You've done very well.
And of course, Kajol Didi, thank you for always helping me at times when I got stuck. And I do remember those days. Yes, you did. I think you forgot.
Kajol helped you when?
I don't remember that.
No,
what are
you doing?
I also don't remember when she helped you.
I just shut up now.
Since it's 20 years of Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, I have to say these things.
Let me just tell you something about Rani. Since we're on this stage, I have to say that the one thing that she never asked for was help. She came, she stood in front of all of us, in front of a Shahrukh Khan, in front of me, in front of Karan. Never showed, yes, she may have been nervous off screen, but never showed that on screen. stood over there, gave her shot like a star, wore the shortest skirts like a star, walked across, walked across the whole of that mind-blowing college that nobody ever knew existed before Karan Johar showed us on screen.
It was not a college, but...
Whatever it was, now shut up. It was on checkered floor or whatever. But she walked very beautifully off along that corridor in high speed. May I just tell you that it's very difficult to walk in high speed in such high heels in a short skirt. So, awesome.
And I love you, Kajol Didi. I love you, Shah. And Karan, I don't need to tell you how much I love you.
And it's all about loving each other. And now that we have finished telling each other how much we love each other, I just want to thank everyone here.
And yes, of course, Tina. Thank you for not doing the film. I love you.
Tina will always be...
Eight heroines who said no to the film. Tina, so thank you.
Tina is omnipresent in the journey of Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. She has been really right through.
And ironically, Tina became a very close friend in the times to come. So I think Kuch Kuch Hota actually I made a huge family. And Gaurima, I have to tell you, in Mauritius, Abraham was 1 year old. Aryan was 1 year old. And I used to play with him in the lobby with him and the nanny.
You played?
Aryan was born
during Kuch Kuch
Hota. Aryan was born after Koi Mil Gaya finished shooting.
Yes.
We finished on the 10th of November, he was born on the 12th.
Yeah, and I remember going down and playing with Aryan in my arms. And I think Shahrukh, I've played with both your kids and now with Abraham as well. So.
Exactly.
That's one thing I have to say about you. You produce very good looking children.
Yeah. Well done. Genetic power.
And I love you, Gaurima, as well.
Thank you.
Gauri, you're taking the credit for this one.
Well, Gauri, you actually thought that we would be thanking you today on this mail. What have you got to do with this?
No, I think Gauri was very, very instrumental.
The only thing Gauri did is she kept Aryan in till that first schedule finished. I was like, please don't deliver. My schedule will go for a toss. That was the one thing that I kept praying for.
No, but Gauri's always been an encouragement all the time. So thank you, Gaurima, for being there always for us.
Yay! All right. Thank you, Rani. Thank you, Shahrukh. Thank you, Kajol. All right. Thank you, Rani. Thank you, Shahrukh. Thank you, Kajol. And thank you to everyone present from Dharma Productions. Thank you to everyone present from Dharma Productions. Thank you. And I have to say that like right now, things are so different for us at Dharma than they were. And I have to thank Apurva for that. He's really structured the new enterprise in such a majestic and an organized fashion. And all the directors and the producers and EPs, members of the team, my marketing team that has worked so diligently on this, to Alpa and Tejasvi and Sid, who heads the department. Thank you so much. You guys are amazing. Thank you to Nilufer, who actually has been like a silent force right through the process, to Garima, who's the mothership who handles it all.
Karan, thank you. Mickey and Manish for always being there first thing in the morning and helping us out.
Yes,
whenever we were nervous. And Mickey, I love you. You have always been a strength to all us girls. So thank you so much for making us look so beautiful.
And Niranjan, let's not forget.
Niranjan, who had nothing to do with Kuch Kuch Hota Hai, but was silently there.
But he has a lot to do with Dharma.
Yeah. Right through. But Niranjan and Dharma go hand in hand. And so all the members, we have all the members of the cast and crew here. To Sony Music, thank you for beginning your journey with us. To the technical crew, the support cast, to music, Jatin Lalit and Samir Saba here. And thank you for just making the music so spectacular. Thank you to the cast, as I can see Archana and of course Farida Ji, we love you. Funny story. Kajol, of course, we tortured you a lot also with your wig and your clothes, and we tried to get that. Mickey was traumatized the first schedule when you had to wear that bob cut because you refused to cut your hair, and you didn't.
Excuse me, what would have happened to that huge big shot that you had of slow motion mein turn karna?
Oh, that second half mein tha na.
Yeah, but I would have grown my hair by that time.
Yeah, but did you get as torched as Bhai says that you cried right through the film? But you did not cry on.
No, I didn't cry. I only remember one thing where y'all were really nasty to me and y'all tried to convince me that I was a junior artist
No, that was Bhai will tell you when.
Both of y'all tried very hard to convince me that I was a junior artist as a backup dancer.
But Bhai will tell you the story. It was in Mauritius in that cycle sequence. What happened to Kajol?
First, he threw me off the bike so that I fell and hit my head. You did.
Only. Yeah, but we were to do a cycle thing, and I think Kajol is not very good at cycling. So we were supposed to ride and leave hands or something, and she had been practicing, and then suddenly she slipped right in front of me. The whole handle turned, and she went flying, and she landed like this on the ground.
On her head, yeah.
On her head, like thup, like that. And because Kajol laughs at everything, then we also naturally laugh at everything. Even
What has that got to do with it?
Because she laughs at so we also ah. And then we went and kind of picked her up and realized it was a little serious. And like, you know, in comic books, you have those little bees and birds and flying. So she like this, and amazingly, she had short-term amnesia. She had lost her memory.
And she truly did. She forgot.
Truly did. First, we thought, you know, it's the shock because she's like, what? She didn't even, I mean, later on, I'll tell you, she didn't even recognize Ajay when we called him and said.
You had no idea.
No, honestly, we called up Ajay to say, and then he'll call Ajay and all. But she forgot everyone. And we took her to the room, and I think we tried to give her some, like, something like Advil of that time or whatever, paracetamol, something. And she had actually lost her memory, and she didn't know who she was, who she was with, what she was doing here. And it was really funny if it wasn't so serious. Actually, it was funny. It wasn't serious at all. And at one point in time, I thought maybe we should now convince her that she's somebody else. So even if she never wakes up from this amnesia, then she will always be that person.
I'll be the backup dancer, basically.
So we kind of told her because, you know, she, me and Kajol both have this issue. We can't dance well. And so I just thought to just, you know, some quirky, weird sense of humor that, you know, maybe if I convince her she's a backup dancer, so when she comes round to it, maybe she'll become a better dancer. Or something like that. It was out of
He told you, convinced her that she's a background dancer.
Background dancer. Out of goodness of my heart to improve your dancing, I just did that. And see, ever since then, have you noticed some of the steps you're getting a little... But she came back. I think a couple of hours of sleep. And then she sort of... and it was afterwards very scary, to be honest, that she genuinely lost her memory.
I still remember the very first day we shot the song Koi Mil Gaya, and Rani was the only one who had rehearsed the song. She had rehearsed it for 15 days because she also had the time at that point. And they were shooting, and so she rehearsed the song, and Kajol and Shahrukh came. They were the superstars, and they walked in and whatever. And Farah was being Farah, and the step started, and they played that Koi Mil Gaya, that song, that step Koi Mil Gaya. And finally, Kajol looked and she's saying, because Rani was doing something totally different. So Kajol looked and said, what is she doing? She's doing it all wrong. And from loud, like the voice of God, Farah said, she is doing it right. Y'all both are doing rubbish. But if anyone knows Farah, they'll know that she says the most inappropriate things on the mic. Once she's even looked at one of the backup dancers and said, why are you looking so sad in the shot? Who died? And she said, actually, my mom last evening. And she got a shock. she was like, oh God. So she can get quite black with her humor. But I remember, Rani, you had the only one who got that right.
And Kajol was nervous as hell because this dress was really short.
Yes, we know.
And we were dancing on the ramp and they were... all the boys and girls.
So there was a whole assistant just designated to make sure that Rani's skirt was like appropriately in place. And of course, Kajol was wonderful. I still remember before I went on set, it was day one of shoot. And she says, listen, the first thing you do is you scream at me. Because if you can scream at me, people will think you're really in control. Because nobody messes with me. So you scream at me. Of course, that plan didn't really work out because I started screaming anyway.
I have to tell you my version of it. This is his version of it. But I gave him this spiel and then I went on set thinking that, you know, oh, he's going to now come on set and he's going to take off on me. So I had like prepared myself totally. Cut to, he turns into like Kali and Chandi on somebody else completely. The guy was pushing the akela or something like that.
These guys were meant to throw, they kept throwing the real balls on you all.
I changed my mind. I was like, he doesn't need anybody. He's got enough of Kali to make a good film out of that.
So, I mean, we'll just end. Thank you and for actually giving me that strength at that time, which was not later on used. But anyway, but Bhai, if I had to ask you what your one memory of the film is, to round up your feeling of this evening and, of course, the film that was.
First, I just want to say I'm seeing this after a long time. And I was very proud when my kids grew up, Aryan and Suhana. not this little Abram. He's not seen it yet. So I'm really glad. This is the first time I think he's come to a function like this with me and sat down. And his first introduction to cinema is Kuch Kuch Hota Hai. So thank you. But now I find it quite creepy, actually. You know, especially the scene where I'm hugging one girl and holding the other. And then I'm lustfully and very, I'm very cheaply looking at this girl whose sari's pallo flies off. Very
it's
creepy.
It's objectification, it's wrong.
It was. It seemed really wrong, and I'm.
And also, actually, it's quite a fraudulent statement you made, which you didn't live up to. You said, "I'm ek hi baar jeete, ek baar marte, pyar bhi ek hi baar hota hai, shaadi." But you fell in love twice, you got married twice, so you were actually your whole philosophy was fraudulent.
No, but then I added, "Kuch kuch hota hai, Anjali, tum nahi samjhoge." Aisa tha wo. Wo maine cover up kar liya tha. Aisa nahi tha. But yeah, my memory would be. I don't know how to describe this memory because it'll involve all of you. Especially Karan, you know, whenever I think of Karan Johar, it'll always be attached to the fact that he made me participate in a film out of his love, more than out of the script. And I remember Tom Uncle always telling me, beta, ye kya kar raha hai? And he used to get sometimes, as a father more than the producer, you know, worried, is he getting it right? And I would always, without knowing myself actually, whether he'll get it right or not, used to be the guy who would tell Tom Uncle, ki, Tom Uncle, ye bahut achha karega. As you know, that's the only way you can counter it. You can't agree with him and come to him, because the one thing that was very clear about Karan was he was like somebody said, you know, he had this very pure emotion. I think Farah mentioned it in an interview. The purity of emotion at that point in time to write this beautiful, innocent love story and live with it and carry it along. Not be affected, as a matter of fact, with established actors like myself, Kajol, and even Rani, and the others. You know, we had Archana, we had Anupam, we had Himani Ji, we had Farida Jalal, so many senior actors around him. But he did not succumb to catering to any part, to anyone else, except to the truth of his story. So to me, the greatest memory is this young boy, and it is extremely encouraging for all the youngsters who are working with Karan, to, I think, take that one thing away from him, whether it's Ishan, Janvi, Varun, tu to young Rani. Jail lagayega to achha ho jayega subah to. Siddharth and all the young boys and girls who Dharma is honing up and training and making them such wonderful stars and actors. The one thing that you need to take away from Karan is the honesty to telling the story that you want to tell. So for me, the biggest memory and the biggest learning, apart from the love and every 10 years, inshallah, when we meet for Kuch Kuch Hota, or any other, the other day also when we were shooting for a film together, Kajol Rani, I am one extremely lucky to get kissed on my both cheeks simultaneously every time I meet Kajol and Rani. Yeah. No man in the world has that luck. So thank you for Kuch Kuch Hota Hai for that. So I got it tonight also. Thank you, ladies, for being so kind and kissy. And of course, like I said, my biggest memory would be that Karan has taught me how to be honest to your work, how to continue doing what you believe in and keep the innocence, retain the innocence of what you want to say in a film, a story, in a poem. And Tina and me just pointed out, we were just thinking that, you know, when he came on stage with your ill-fitting suit for that Filmfare Award, and now such wonderful clothes you wear. It's stunning what you are dressed up as.
It's really stunning.
It's really nice. You know, 40 years from now, when we come for Kuch Kuch Hota again, we'll have to make a similar kind of comment. Who made these pants?
That's my Sindhi legacy. I have to wear
But
shine.
I want to know what's written. Is Kuch Kuch Hota written?
No, it says Philip.
Hashtag KKH?
No, it's not.
All right. So, like she said, you know, he came on stage that he would have to wait. And I think even Karina mentioned it, that he'd have to wait for years or become a compare to hold the mic on the Filmfare stage. It's so strange that being, according to me, not even arguably, according to me, honestly, the greatest director this country has produced in modern times, I think he should make more cinema as a director. He should write more films. It's not my memories. It's what I really would love to see in my lifetime and my children's lifetimes and all the youngsters, that if Karan Johar can make a lot more movies, not like Kuch Kuch Hota necessarily, whatever he feels like, because the one thing I learned from Karan is, if you feel it right, you can't go wrong. So make us feel more right with more beautiful films like this. And thank you very much for teaching me that through Kuch Kuch Hota Hai.
And